A very good morning, friends. Today we will discuss about an important topic, that is sickle cell anemia. This is named because there is formation of sickle RBCs which occludes the blood vessels, and that leads to the hemolytic anemia. Coming to the genetic basis of sickle cell anemia, it is an abnormal hemoglobin. It is a most common abnormal hemoglobin, that is hemoglobin S, abnormal hemoglobin variant. Now, this is, if you think at the DNA level, in the DNA, there is C, T, C. In hemoglobin S or sickle cell anemia, there is mutation in this thymine, and this T is replaced by the adenine. Thymine is replaced by the adenine. So this results in the CAC. At the RNA level, that is mRNA level, this GAG. In the hemoglobin S, there is GUG. So there is replacement of this adenine by the uracil in the mRNA. Now this GAG, it codes for the amino acid glutamate. And this GUG, it codes for the valine. So this happens in the beta chain, sixth position of beta chain. Of hemoglobin. So there is replacement. This glutamate is replaced by valine at the sixth position of beta chain, that results in the formation of hemoglobin, that is known as abnormal hemoglobin or hemoglobin S. Hemoglobin S. This is hemoglobin A. This hemoglobin A, due to the glutamate, it carries more negative charge and it is a polar, more soluble hemoglobin. While this hemoglobin, it is a non-polar, and this is due to the valine, which is non-polar, and due to this valine, there is decrease in the solubility of hemoglobin S. So this is the genetic basis. It is a mutation that is known as point mutation. It is a missense type of point mutation, which is partially acceptable. It is a partially acceptable missense point mutation. That means there is mutation, there is substitution of single base. At DNA level, this thymine is replaced by the adenine. Then it is a missense, means change in a base sequence results in the change in an amino acid. So here glutamate is replaced by valine. So that is known as missense. And partially acceptable means it is a condition which is compatible with the life. That's why it is known as partially acceptable missense point mutation. There are two main types, that is SS pattern or homozygous state, which is due to the inheritance of gene from the both the parents. And second is the AS pattern, due to the inheritance of only single gene. That is known as AS pattern. It is also known as sickle cell trait or sickle cell carrier, while this is known as sickle cell disease. Now we'll see the mechanism behind the sickling of RBC. In the mechanism behind the sickling, we'll first see the structure of various hemoglobin. Suppose this is a hemoglobin A, that is normal hemoglobin. Then this is deoxyhemoglobin. It has receptor. It has receptor for the sticky patch. So it is deoxyhemoglobin A. Now the hemoglobin S, oxyhemoglobin S, it is having the sticky patch but do not have the receptor for this sticky patch. Then deoxyhemoglobin S it is with the complementary patch to the sticky patch and also the sticky patch. So this is deoxyhemoglobin S. The sickled RBC is due to the formation of fiber, which is due to the polymerization of this deoxyhemoglobin S. When there is decreased supply of oxygen, there is polymerization of deoxyhemoglobin S occurs. So this is deoxyhemoglobin S. This is a complementary patch. This is a sticky patch. This is again complementary patch and this is a sticky patch. Now there is polymerization occurs. So this is the polymerization of deoxyhemoglobin S, which results in the formation of fiber which distorts the shape of RBC into a sickled shape. And this sickled RBC occludes the microvasculature, which leads to the pain distal to the blockade. So pain is the main symptom in the sickle cell anemia. So if it is in the oxygenated state, there is more hemoglobin S and sickling can be prevented. Sickling is mainly in the deoxygenated state due to the receptor and sticky patch which is present on deoxyhemoglobin S due to replacement of glutamate by valine. This glutamate is replaced by valine at the sixth position of beta chain. So this is the molecular basis and mechanism behind the sickling in sickle cell anemia. Now coming to the clinical features, in the homozygous state or when it is a SS pattern, the main features are, main is the pain, which is due to the occlusion of microvasculature, and distal to the occlusion there is necrosis, damage of the tissue which results in the pain. Then hemolytic anemia due to the rapid destruction of RBCs. Due to the breakdown of heme, there is jaundice, which is hemolytic jaundice. Then there is hepatomegaly, splenomegaly, that is known as hepatosplenomegaly. It results in the various complication or crises. So it include crisis. The first important is the pain crisis, which is due to the blockade in the microvasculature. It includes the acute chest syndrome when there is blockade in the vessels of lungs and heart. It results in the acute chest syndrome. Then second one is the aplastic crisis. It is due to the infection by the parvovirus B19. When there is infection by the parvovirus B19, it leads to the aplastic crisis. Then sequestration crisis. It is due to the pooling of blood in the spleen that results in the rapid lowering of the hemoglobin. That is known as sequestration crisis. So these are the main pain crisis or acute chest syndrome, then aplastic crisis, sequestration crisis. Then it can result in the complication like stroke, priapism, etc. So due to the damage to the spleen by the infarction at the age of 2 to 4 years, it leads to the repeated infection by the repeated infection by the Streptococcus pneumoniae. So the vaccination against the capsulated organism is recommended in the patient with sickle cell anemia. Now coming to the laboratory diagnosis. In the laboratory diagnosis, the screening test is the one that is known as Sickling test or solubility test in lab diagnosis. First one is the solubility test or Sickling test, which is by the peripheral smear by adding a reducing agent, that is sodium metabisulfite or sodium dithionite, is added and sickled RBCs are observed under the microscope. This is the first solubility test. Second is the hemoglobin electrophoresis. In hemoglobin electrophoresis, if this is a hemoglobin electrophoresis, this is the normal patient, this is the sickle cell disease, and this is sickle cell trait. This is hemoglobin A, this is hemoglobin S. Hemoglobin S, it moves slowly in electrophoresis due to the less negative charge. This is positive terminal, this is negative terminal. So hemoglobin S, this is the pattern in sickle cell disease. In sickle cell trait, there is slow moving and this fast moving component, two band, that is known as AS pattern. And in normal patient, there is hemoglobin A, which is fast moving component. So this is a pattern. In sickle cell trait, you will get AS pattern. In sickle cell disease, there is SS pattern. And in normal, there is hemoglobin A. And it is now widely replaced by the HPLC technique, that is high performance liquid chromatography, which is a preferred investigation of choice in sickle cell anemia nowadays. Now coming to the treatment. In the treatment, the hydroxyurea is given, which decreases the sequestration or which decreases the occlusion of blood vessels and relieves the symptoms. Then frequent blood transfusions, then sodium cyanide is given, and the stem cell transplant therapy it is the preferred mode for the treatment, stem cell transplant therapy. And there is awaited therapy, that is gene therapy for the sickle cell disease. So this is all about the sickle cell anemia. You may get a case and short note in a university examination on this topic. So keep watching. Thank you.